ever asked you to go and wash the germs off your hands? Well, those germs are actually very tiny living things called bacteria. There are many different kinds of bacteria. These are very, very tiny. So tiny that millions of them can fit on the tip of your finger. Because they are so small, you can't see billions of them are in the air, on your skin, and even inside your body. Bacteria may be small, but many of them are quite tough and can live just about anywhere. Bacteria often get a bad reputation because some of them cause disease, but many others are completely harmless. Some bacteria even do good things for us, such as turn milk into cheese. But do you know, out of the five kingdoms, to which kingdom do they belong? How do they look like? How these bacteria reproduce? Okay, let us check it out.
Hello students, I welcome you all to today's lesson about the kingdom having organisms which were among the first life forms on earth. ਤੁਸੀਂ ਚੰਗੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਜਾਣਦੇ ਹੋ ਕਿ ਇਸ ਧਰਤੀ ਤੇ ਸਜੀਵਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੰਜ ਜਗਤਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੰਡਿਆ ਗਿਆ ਹੈ। ਪੰਜ ਜਗਤਾਂ ਵਾਲੀ ਵੰਡ ਦੀ ਤਜਵੀਜ਼ ਆਰ ਐਚ ਵਿਟਕਰ ਨੇ 1969 ਵਿੱਚ ਕੀਤੀ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਪੰਜ ਜਗਤ ਵੰਡ ਪ੍ਰਣਾਲੀ ਕਿਹਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ। ਸਜੀਵਾਂ ਦੀ ਸ਼੍ਰੇਣੀ ਵੰਡ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਦਿਖਾਈ ਦੇਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਲੱਛਣਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਪੋਸ਼ਣ ਦੇ ਤਰੀਕਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਆਧਾਰ ਤੇ ਕੀਤਾ ਗਿਆ ਹੈ। ਇਸ ਸ਼੍ਰੇਣੀ ਵੰਡ ਨੇ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਦੋ ਜਗਤ ਵੰਡ ਪ੍ਰਣਾਲੀ ਨੂੰ ਰੱਦ ਕਰਕੇ ਉਸ ਦੀ ਥਾਂ ਲਈ। ਆਰ ਐਚ ਵਿਟਕਰ ਕਲਾਸੀਫਾਈਡ ਦ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਔਰਗੈਨਿਜ਼ਮਸ ਇੰਟੂ ਫਾਈਵ ਕਿੰਗਡਮਸ, ਨੇਮਲੀ ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ, ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਪ੍ਰੋਟਿਸਟਾ, ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਫੰਜਾਏ, ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਪਲਾਂਟੇ ਐਂਡ ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਐਨੀਮੇਲੀਆ।
If we look at this five kingdom system classification, Monera represents the earliest group of organisms. You know, Monera are thought to have given rise to Protista. From Protista, the three other kingdoms of organisms, namely the fungi, plantae, and animalia, evolved as shown here in the visual. Monera includes prokaryotes like eubacteria and archaebacteria. Individuals are single-celled, even some of them are non-motile. They do not possess chloroplasts, nucleus, or other organelles. They do have a cell wall. Examples of this kingdom Monera are bacteria and blue-green algae. Our next kingdom is Protista. Protists are single-celled organisms. They are identified by their mode of movement. They usually move by using cilia, flagella, or pseudopodia. Examples include red algae, slime molds, amoebas, and protozoans. From this Protista kingdom, as I have already told, that the other three kingdoms evolved. These are fungi, plantae, and animalia. If we look at the features of the kingdom fungi, these are predominantly multicellular with a cell wall, organelles including a nucleus, but no chloroplasts. Fungi range in size from microscopic to very large, such as mushrooms. Plants are multicellular and have a complicated body. Organelles including nucleus, chloroplasts are present, and cell walls are present. And you know, food is manufactured by the process of photosynthesis in the plants. animals are multicellular and have more complex body than plants. Their body makes movement with the help of special appendages. Cells present in animals have organelles, including a nucleus, but no chloroplast or cell walls. Animals acquire nutrients by ingestion.
Students, this was the five kingdom system of classification proposed by R. H. Whitaker. You saw these five kingdoms: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. In each of the lesson, as we are taking one kingdom, today's discussion is about the kingdom Monera. What will be your learning after today's lesson? Let me tell you before starting the main topic.
Upon completion of this topic, learners will be able to discuss kingdom Monera. Name the important groups of Monera. Describe the important characteristics of the kingdom Monera. Describe the important characteristics, occurrence and features of members of eubacteria, that is, bacteria and cyanobacteria.
ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਪਾਠ ਦੇ ਲਰਨਿੰਗ ਆਬਜੈਕਟਿਵਸ ਜਾਣਨ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਬਾਰੇ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਹਾਂ। ਮੋਨੇਰੈਂਸ, ਜਿਵੇਂ ਕਿ ਮੈਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਵੀ ਦੱਸਿਆ ਹੈ, ਇਹ ਧਰਤੀ ਤੇ ਵਿਸ਼ਾਲ ਅਤੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਪ੍ਰਕਾਰੀ ਸਜੀਵ ਸਮੂਹ ਹਨ। ਇਹ ਪ੍ਰੋਕਰਿਓਟਿਕ ਸਜੀਵਾਂ ਦਾ ਉਹ ਸਮੂਹ ਹੈ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਿਊਕਲੀਅਸ ਅਤੇ ਝਿੱਲੀ ਵਾਲੀਆਂ ਔਰਗੈਨਲੀਸ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ। ਇਹਨਾਂ ਪ੍ਰੋਕਰਿਓਟਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਬਹੁਤ ਪੁਰਾਤਨ, ਛੋਟੇ, ਸਰਲ ਅਤੇ ਵਿਸ਼ਾਲ ਮਾਤਰਾ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਜੀਵ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਨ। ਇੱਥੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਦੀਆਂ ਦੋ ਸ਼੍ਰੇਣੀਆਂ, ਯੂ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਅਤੇ ਆਰਕੀਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਬਾਰੇ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਂਗੇ। ਬਟ ਫਸਟ ਆਫ ਆਲ, ਲੈਟ ਅਸ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਦ ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਇਨ ਡਿਟੇਲ।
ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ। ਦੀ ਮੋਨੇਰਨਸ ਆਰ ਦੀ ਮੋਸਟ ਨਿਊਮਰਸ ਐਂਡ ਵਾਈਡ ਸਪਰੈਡ ਆਰਗੇਨਿਜ਼ਮਸ ਔਨ ਅਰਥ। ਦ ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਇਨਕਲੂਡਸ Eubacteria and Archaebacteria. These one-celled organisms are prokaryotic. Prokaryotic organisms, you know, have neither nucleus nor organelles in their cytoplasm, but possess only a single chromosome and have small ribosomes. As you already know, bacteria are found everywhere. They come in a vast array of shapes and sizes. Take a look on different shapes and sizes of bacteria, but do you remember these bacteria are extremely small? The four basic shapes are cocci, bacillus, spirillum, and vibrio. We will learn about these different shapes in detail in the later part of this topic. Eubacteria are called the true bacteria, which are the majority of 10,000 species in the Moneran group. Eubacteria can be categorized into two types: gram-negative Eubacteria, gram-positive Eubacteria. These bacteria are classified on the basis of gram stain. Gram positive are those bacteria which retain purple stain after staining with gram stain. These are flagellated and have thin cell wall. Common examples are Diplococcus, Salmonella typhi, and Streptococcus. Gram-negative are those bacteria which are decolorized with gram stain. These are non-flagellated with wavy cell wall. Common examples are E. coli, Vibrio cholerae, and bacillus and thrasis. Archaebacteria are the ancient bacteria. Being the minority of the moneran group, they are only found in extreme environments such as swamps, salt lakes, and deep ocean hydrothermal vents.
ਵਿਦਿਆਰਥੀਓ ਇਹ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਜਗਤ ਦੇ ਕੁਝ ਵਿਸ਼ੇਸ਼ ਲੱਛਣ ਹਨ ਇਹ ਸਾਰੀ ਸੂਚਨਾ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਹਿ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਜਗਤ ਵਿੱਚ ਇੱਕ ਸੈਲੇ ਸਜੀਵ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਆਉਂਦੇ ਹਨ ਇਹ ਜਾਣਨ ਲਈ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਛੋਟੇ ਹਨ ਤਾਂ ਵੇਖੋ 1 ਮਿਲੀਮੀਟਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਈ ਹਜ਼ਾਰ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਹੋ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਨ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਛੋਟੇ ਆਕਾਰ ਦੇ ਬਾਵਜੂਦ ਵੀ ਇਹ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਧਰਤੀ ਤੋਂ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵੱਧ ਮਾਤਰਾ ਵਿੱਚ ਮਿਲਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਸਜੀਵ ਹਨ ਅਤੇ ਇਹ ਹਰ ਥਾਂ ਤੇ ਮੌਜੂਦ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਨ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਹਵਾ ਪਾਣੀ ਮਿੱਟੀ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਅਤੇ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਅੰਦਰ ਵੀ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਦੀ ਖੋਜ ਡੱਚ ਵਿਗਿਆਨੀ ਐਂਟਨੀ ਵੈਨ ਲਿਊਵਨਹੌਕ ਨੇ ਕੀਤੀ ਸੀ ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਯੂ ਮਸਟ ਬੀ ਕਿਊਰੀਅਸ ਬਾਈ ਨਾਓ ਟੂ ਚੈੱਕ ਦੈਮ ਸੋ ਲੈਟਸ ਹੈਵ ਅ ਲੁੱਕ ਐਟ ਦ ਬੇਸਿਕ ਕੈਰੇਕਟਰਿਸਟਿਕਸ ਆਫ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ
ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ Occurrence. As discussed earlier, bacteria are so widespread and found anywhere and everywhere. They may be found on the tops of mountains, the bottom of the deepest oceans, in the guts of animals, and even in the frozen rocks and ice of Antarctica. Size. As far as the size of bacteria is concerned, they are smaller than other cells but larger than viruses. The average size of bacterial cell ranges from 1 micrometer to 10 micrometer in length and from 0.7 micrometer to 1.5 micrometer in width. The largest bacterium is Begitua mirabilis, which is 16 to 45 microns in diameter and several centimeters long. Shape. Cell wall of bacteria plays an important role in determining its shape. The vast majority of bacteria have a cell wall containing a special polymer which is partly protein and partly polysaccharide and called as peptidoglycan. The cell wall lies outside the cell membrane. The rigid peptidoglycan is important in defining the shape of the cell. If this cell wall is removed by digesting the peptidoglycan with the enzyme lysozyme, all cells, regardless of their original shape, becomes spheres. However, there are four basic shapes that bacterial cells adopt. They are either round, rod-shaped, or spiral and comma-shaped. The first type of shape is known as coccus. These are spherical, ellipsoidal, or ovoid in shape. Streptococcus is the common example of this type. Coccus form, when exists singly, is known as micrococcus. If it is in pairs, then it is known as diplococcus. If the cells are present in chains, then they are known as streptococcus. While staphylococcus forms live in clusters like a bunch of grapes. The second type of shape is the rod-shaped bacteria, which are known as bacilli or bacillus. The term bacillus means a rod-shaped bacterium. Escherichia coli and Bacillus anthracis, a pathogen causing anthrax in sheep and humans, are the examples of this type. Spiral-shaped bacteria are the largest of these four types and simplest to identify. The spirillum bacteria are spiral or coil-like. Spirillum and spirochetae are examples of this type. The fourth kind of shape is coma-shaped bacteria known as vibrio, example Vibrio cholerae.
These shapes of bacterial cells which we discussed just now is of fundamental importance in the classification and identification of bacteria. Although bacteria are of four basic shapes, they display an astonishing variety of forms when viewed microscopically. If we talk about their oxygen requirement and mode of cellular respiration, most bacteria may be placed into one of two major groups. Bacteria which need oxygen for their survival are called aerobic bacteria. Other bacteria are anaerobic bacteria. These do not require oxygen for survival. Anaerobic bacteria cannot bear oxygen and may die if kept in oxygenated environment. They are found in places like under the surface of earth and deep ocean. Both aerobic and anaerobic bacteria may be facultative or obligate. Facultative aerobes are bacteria which respire anaerobically under normal conditions but can respire aerobically when oxygen is available. Facultative anaerobes respire only aerobically but switch over to anaerobic respiration if oxygen becomes deficient. Obligate aerobes can respire only aerobically and get killed under anaerobic conditions. Obligate anaerobe respire only anaerobically but killed under aerobic conditions. Bacteria may also be classified on the basis of the mode by which they obtain their energy. They may be heterotrophs, which derive energy from breaking down complex organic compounds that they must take in from the environment. This includes saprobic bacteria found in decaying material. The other group, known as the autotrophs, which you know fixes carbon dioxide to make their own food source. This may be done by light energy as in photoautotrophic bacteria or by oxidation of nitrogen, sulfur or other element as in chemoautotrophic bacteria. After studying the important characteristics of the bacteria, let us now see how reproduction takes place in bacteria.
Reproduction in bacteria. You are probably most familiar with mitosis as the mode by which cells reproduce themselves. Because prokaryotes have a single circular chromosome rather than the sets of chromosomes found in more familiar eukaryotes, mitosis does not occur in prokaryotes. Instead, most of the bacteria reproduce by a process of binary fission. In this, the cell duplicates its components and divides into two cells. The newly produced cells usually become independent, but they may remain attached in linear chains or grape-like clusters. In bacterial sexual reproduction, there is no meiosis, formation of gametes and zygote. Instead, it involves transfer of a portion of genetic material, that is DNA, from a donor cell to a recipient cell. This process is called as genetic recombination or parasexuality. It is known to occur in three ways. Transformation, which is the transfer of naked DNA from one bacterial cell to another. During this process, small amount of DNA is transferred intracellularly from one bacterial cell to another, where it gets integrated with the DNA of recipient bacterium. Transduction, which is the transfer of viral, bacterial, or both bacterial and viral DNA from one cell to another via bacteriophage. Conjugation is the transfer of DNA from one bacterial cell to another via a special protein structure called a conjugation pilus.
ਤੁਸੀਂ ਵੇਖਿਆ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਵੱਖ-ਵੱਖ ਤਰੀਕਿਆਂ ਨਾਲ ਪ੍ਰਜਨਨ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਨ। ਇਹ ਕਈ ਤਰੀਕਿਆਂ ਨਾਲ ਮਨੁੱਖੀ ਜੀਵਨ ਨੂੰ ਪ੍ਰਭਾਵਿਤ ਵੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਨ। ਇਹ ਸਾਡੇ ਲਈ ਬੇਸ਼ੱਕ ਲਾਭਦਾਇਕ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਨ, ਪਰ ਕਈ ਵਾਰੀ ਬਿਮਾਰੀਆਂ ਦਾ ਕਾਰਨ ਬਣ ਕੇ ਨੁਕਸਾਨ ਵੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਨ। ਆਓ ਦੇਖਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਸਾਡੇ ਲਈ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਆਰਥਿਕ ਤੌਰ 'ਤੇ ਫਾਇਦੇਮੰਦ ਹਨ।
Economic importance of bacteria. Nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixing bacteria like Azotobacter and Rhizobium take nitrogen gas from the atmosphere and convert it to nitrate that green plants use for growth. Decomposers. Some bacteria naturally decompose organic remains of dead plants and animals in the soil, hence increases soil fertility. Sewage disposal. The modern septic tank sewage disposal use bacteria in sewage treatment and also in biogas production. Use in industries. Bacteria like Acetobacter acetae convert alcohol into acetic acid, which is used in the manufacture of vinegar. Others convert lactic acid into butyric acid, which is used in the manufacture of cheese and sealage fermentation. Bacteria are important in the manufacture of glycerin, acetone, and tanning of leather, while some are used in curing tobacco and tea leaves. Bacteria are also useful in the manufacture of enzymes like invertase, catalase, lipase, which are used in food and textile industries. Medicinal use. Bacteria are important in manufacturing of antibiotics. For example, Streptomycetes species are used to make tetracycline and streptomycin. Vitamin synthesis. Escherichia coli living in human colon synthesize vitamin B and release it for human use. Similarly, Clostridium botulicum is used for commercial preparation of riboflavin, a type of vitamin B. Pest control. Bacteria can also be used as pesticides in the biological pest control. This commonly used Bacillus thuringiensis, also called BT, is a gram-positive soil-dwelling bacterium.
ਵਿਦਿਆਰਥੀਓ, ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਦੇ ਕੁਝ ਆਰਥਿਕ ਲਾਭਾਂ ਬਾਰੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਪੜ੍ਹ ਲਿਆ ਹੈ। ਭਾਵੇਂ ਕਿ ਕਈ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਟੌਕਸਿਨਸ ਪਾਓ ਜ਼ਹਿਰੀਲੇ ਪਦਾਰਥ ਪੈਦਾ ਕਰਕੇ ਸਾਡੇ ਭੋਜਨ ਨੂੰ ਖਰਾਬ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਨ, ਇਸ ਲਈ ਇਹ ਕੁਝ ਨੁਕਸਾਨਦਾਇਕ ਵੀ ਹਨ। ਇਹ ਭੋਜਨ ਨੂੰ ਵਰਤੋਂਯੋਗ ਨਹੀਂ ਰਹਿਣ ਦਿੰਦੇ। ਇਹ ਮਨੁੱਖ ਲਈ, ਫਸਲਾਂ ਲਈ ਅਤੇ ਜਾਨਵਰਾਂ ਲਈ ਕਈ ਬਿਮਾਰੀਆਂ ਦਾ ਕਾਰਨ ਬਣਦੇ ਹਨ। ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਹੋਣ ਵਾਲੀਆਂ ਕੁਝ ਬਿਮਾਰੀਆਂ ਹਨ ਬੋਟਿਊਲਿਜ਼ਮ, ਟਾਈਫਾਇਡ ਯਾਨੀ ਮਿਆਦੀ ਬੁਖਾਰ, ਕੋਲਰਾ ਯਾਨੀ ਹੈਜਾ ਅਤੇ ਐਂਥਰੈਕਸ ਆਦਿ। ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਜਗਤ ਦੇ ਮਹੱਤਵਪੂਰਨ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਦੇ ਅਗਲੇ ਅੰਸ਼ ਸਾਇਨੋ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਬਾਰੇ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਂਗੇ।
Cyanobacteria are aquatic and photosynthetic. That is, they live in marine and fresh water. They are also found in moist soil, damp places, and on tree bark, as shown here in the visual. They are also found in hot water springs. Some common cyanobacteria are Anabina, Oscillatoria, Nostoc, etc. They can manufacture their own food. They often grow in colonies large enough to see. They have the distinction of being the oldest known fossils. Because they are photosynthetic and aquatic, cyanobacteria are often called blue-green algae. Economically, blue-green algae is very important. Some cyanobacteria are sold as food. Humans also consume spirulina, which contains all amino acids essential for humans. It forms a staple food in parts of Africa and Mexico. In China, Taiwan, and Japan, several blue greens are served as a delicacy. Worldwide, it is cultured and commercially processed for various food and medicinal products such as vitamins, drug compounds, and growth factors, and also for the production of hydrogen gas and fertilizers. So, the utilization of blue greens in food production and in solar energy conversion may hold immense potential for the future and could be exploited for man's economy.
ਵਿਦਿਆਰਥੀਓ, ਇਹ ਨੀਲੀ ਹਰੀ ਕਾਈ ਨਾ ਤੇ ਕਾਈ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਨਾ ਹੀ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ। ਇਹਨਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਦੋਵੇਂ ਹੀ ਲੱਛਣ ਹਨ ਅਤੇ ਇਹ ਦੋਹਾਂ ਦੇ ਵਿਕਾਸ ਦੇ ਸੰਬੰਧ ਦਾ ਸਬੂਤ ਹਨ। ਜੇ ਸੈੱਲ ਬਣਤਰ ਨੂੰ ਵੇਖੀਏ ਤਾਂ ਉਹ ਬੈਕਟੀਰੀਆ ਜਾਪਦੇ ਹਨ, ਪਰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਪ੍ਰਕਾਸ਼ ਸੰਸ਼ਲੇਸ਼ਣ ਯੋਗਤਾ ਅਤੇ ਪਿਗਮੈਂਟਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਉਹ ਕਾਈ ਹਨ। ਪੈ ਗਏ ਨਾ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਅਚੰਭੇ ਵਿੱਚ? ਪਰ ਚਿੰਤਾ ਨਾ ਕਰੋ, ਇਹ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਮਹੱਤਵਪੂਰਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਕੋਈ ਹੋਰ ਨਾਮਕਰਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਨ ਲੱਗੇ। ਸੋ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟਸ, ਦਿਸ ਵਾਸ ਆਲ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਮੋਨੇਰਾ, ਐਂਡ ਵਿਦ ਦਿਸ ਵੀ ਕੰਕਲੂਡ ਆਰ ਟੂਡੇਜ਼ ਲੈਸਨ। ਹੇਅਰ ਇਜ਼ ਵਾਟ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਲਰਨਡ ਫਰੋਮ ਦਿਸ ਯੂਨਿਟ। 5 ਕਿੰਗਡਮ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਆਫ ਕਲਾਸੀਫਿਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਇਜ਼ ਪ੍ਰਪੋਜ਼ਡ ਬਾਏ ਆਰ ਐਚ ਵਿਟਕਰ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਈਅਰ 1969. ਵਿਟਕਰ ਕਲਾਸੀਫਾਈਡ ਦਾ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਆਰਗੈਨਿਜ਼ਮਸ into 5 kingdoms, namely Kingdom Monera, Protista, Plantae, Fungi, and Animalia. Monera represents the earliest group of organisms. Kingdom Monera includes prokaryotes like Eubacteria and Archaebacteria. Bacteria are found everywhere. They come in a vast array of shapes and sizes. The 4 basic shapes are cocci, bacillus,
spirillum,
and vibrio. Eubacteria can be categorized into 2 types, gram-negative bacteria and gram-positive bacteria. Mitosis does not occur in prokaryotes. Instead, most of the bacteria
reproduce
by a process of binary fission. In bacterial sexual reproduction, there is a transfer of a portion of genetic material, that is, DNA from a donor cell to a recipient cell. This process is called as genetic recombination or parasexuality. Most important bacteria are harmless to humans, and many bacteria are essential or useful to the existence of plant and animal life. Bacteria enrich the soil by fixing nitrogen from the atmosphere. bacteria also create fertilizer by breaking down compost heaps made of soil and dead plant matter. Bacteria are important industrially in the production of cheese, yogurt, buttermilk and vinegar, in the preparation of antibiotics such as streptomycin. Cyanobacteria are aquatic and photosynthetic, that is, they live in marine and fresh water. Cyanobacteria are often called blue-green algae. So students, enough for today. Let's quickly check with some short questions what you have grabbed today. Be attentive. Here are some questions. The first question is, name different kingdoms proposed by Whitaker. The answer is Monera, Protista, Plantae, Fungi and Animalia. The next question is, what are prokaryotes? Well, the answer is, prokaryotes are those organisms which lack a nucleus or other membrane-bounded organelles. The next question is, name the scientist who discovered the bacteria. Well, the answer is, Antony van Leeuwenhoek was the scientist who discovered the bacteria. Well, my next question is, name two groups of Kingdom Monera. The answer is, two groups of Kingdom Monera are Eubacteria, the true bacteria, and
Archaebacteria.
The next question is, what is the average size of bacterial cell? The answer is, bacterial cell size ranges from 1 micrometer to 10 micrometer in length and from 0.7 micrometer to 1.5 micrometer in width. The next question is, name the largest bacteria. Well, the answer is Bagyotoa mirabilis. Another question to you is, what is the chemical substance present in bacteria cell wall? Well, the answer is
peptidoglycan.
Another question is, name three types of genetic recombination that occur in bacteria. The answer is transformation, transduction, and conjugation. The next question is, what is the common name of rod-shaped bacteria? The answer is bacillus. Now another question is, name the bacteria responsible for nitrogen fixation in leguminous plants. The answer is rhizobium. Next question is, list some fields of economic importance of bacteria. The answer is nitrogen fixation, use in industry, and medicinal use. Hope I have made a successful attempt to clear your concepts regarding Kingdom Monera, which will help you in fetching good marks in the exam. Thanks for your cooperation and attention. Looking forward to the next class. See you then. Thanks.